absolute. And you can't be the chief, any colonel can't become the chief of the army staff within a year or anything, immediately. He has to go through that grind. You can't just jump steps in the
But I think I'll agree with this point to an extent, because keeping that experience also, just an opinion, short of thought. But yes, there are education institutes which are just commercially, you know, not laying the foundation the way realistically it should be laid.
See, education nowhere teaches you, okay, you're going to get the best job in the industry. Education doesn't teach you this.
Shall I say something about being, since I can say with a little bit of knowledge about defense services? When you are into an NDA, when you are in, or you pass out your IMA, or you do an OT, which is officer training department, for short service completely, and I can say it with some authority. What happens? Nobody on earth can challenge that you will not become a lieutenant colonel, except for OT and people. You cannot compare archaic government setups with the private world. The meritocracy is lost in government world. Okay, I'll give you a very small example, what the army grudges about. Leave the one man, one pension apart. In army, to become a colonel, you have to sit for two boards, and you better be competent to become some colonel, brigadier, and there are very few major generals who, to become a general, whatever be the general you are, you're somebody. In fact, to become, to command a troop of 1,000 people as a colonel is a big thing. In fact, the guy feels to become a colonel of the army first. Even today, if you are lieutenant general and the senior most in the regiment, you call it colonel of the regiment. That is the kind of respect a colonel has. Now, sir, in IPS, have you ever seen a guy not become a DG? In Punjab, there are 5 DGs. DG housing, DG this, DG that, DG that. There is a lot of apathy. There is a lot of difference, sir. So I'm not trying to pit army against the IAS or IPS. You think people join IAS, IPS for what exactly it is? Sir, the salary of an IAS, IPS and a colonel is supposedly the same in white. SSP, sir, what is an SSP? What rank does he wear? A lieutenant colonel's rank is equal to an SSP. Let me complete my point. In Chandigarh's SSP car, you touch his car and you touch a car of a lieutenant colonel, you will get what kind of reactions you will understand. The thing is, to become an IAS IPS officer or to join the IAMS, we forget where the, you are talking about the society, I say where the parents and the kid go wrong. They have not actually studied, but they feel that MBA is a great equalizer. Suddenly after doing MBA, they will become CEO. So it is not a great equalizer. MBAs are made in the world only for one thing, to become good corporate employees. And that's the definition of an MBA. MBAs are not supposed to be the chairmen of company. No, they can be the, they're supposed to be. See, in MBA, I was taught a subject called a strategic mark, strategic management. Believe you me, I went and told my sir, he was to come from Asian Institute of Management, Manila. Very nice guy. Some Bengali guy, I forgot his name. I said, sir, मेरे को इसमें समझ क्या आएगा strategic management का? ये तो CEO की है. ना तेरा course है ना तू पढ़. So in MBA also there are certain things which are taught which have no relevance. Now how will I relate in my life? What you going to do with 500 crores? How am I going to relate on that 500 crores? It's of no consequence to me.
So we can ask
Arna,
who's this 14? Are you 14 or 15? 15. So 15-year-old two chaps.
Okay, 15.
16. So they've come up, you know, for this talk, and I've been seeing them actively. Most of the Thai events, you know, I just see not even, you know, 1% participation of kids of your age. What brings you here? And what is your opinion about what they are discussing?
I'm going to tell you one thing, that education to me also is not just getting marks. I participate in my class, like, I want to learn something. I'm not, like, I'll do this MBA and, like, become CEO or something. I'll open my but I just want to grab knowledge so that I can put that knowledge when I grow up, and I should be street smart enough to make my business work. So I just want myself to be educated. I never go with the marks. I know I have to get marks in order to get into a good college, but like I'm not Singaporean right now.
Yeah. to further confirm this, I'm a simple graduate.
Sure.
And I worked for a few companies, 3 to 4 years. Then recently I started my own company that is huge successful. We are the fastest growing incubator by Mohali, Gopinath Government of India. So what I learned is this is practical experience that I learned. Like I work with so many situations, I handle the critical, you know, challenges. And how we solve those challenges with our ability, this makes me, right now I'm handling around 50 people. So this management skills, these business skills, these basically grown up day by day with the challenges dealing we must face. So education for me, even I think, we learn few things, those are highly critical in technology. We just need to understand how we can make this. But at the end, education is not helping me. What I learned from BTech and graduation, that was not helping me at all. So the major thing that was the reality and the experience that I was getting day-to-day life. And the mentors that I have, I mean, few good people, those are basically sharpening skills and all. So education matters, but it doesn't matter up to that level, because I think most of the IITians cannot open their companies, because only people those can take risk and they have faced some challenges in the life, they can make successful companies. So my opinion is same. I think education matters, but not up to the level that if you would like to start your own company, then education is good. Then you must be aware about the domain knowledge of that particular business that you are doing. That doesn't mean business skills and these management skills is basically automatically grows up when you know.
I also feel that I'm not trying to give a discourse that education is not good. I start with that.
But what when he was narrating his experience, we can clearly see a difference between a management guy and an entrepreneur.
Absolutely.
So that is very obvious in his statement. So that difference need to be there, and we need to identify that.
So is it the opportunity?
This is the opportunity and how you grab that. That opportunity everyone cannot grab that.
See,
you must have that.
Doesn't get it also. So would you like to complete on what you were saying?
Yeah, what I wanted to say, elaborate on it, going further with the discussion. That see, everybody is driven with their own strengths and weaknesses.
Sure.
And absolutely, we don't accept ourselves. Rather, I'll say, we don't discover ourselves. Okay. If I have a certain set of competencies, some skills I have, I have to know, okay, I am suited for the hospitality industry. I'm suited for army, I'm suited for particular leadership, I'm suited for ABC professions and all. Now when I select a particular profession, definitely I have an icon in mind.
Absolutely. That's what drives you.
The top three. And we all aspire to be that, wherever you are, whichever profession you are. So I think that is the destination. We have to realize, to reach the destination, you have to undertake that journey.
Absolutely.
We don't want to undertake that journey. So no education teaches you to undertake that journey. But that's how to undertake that journey, you've got to be spiritually enlightened. You have to be realized, nothing comes without a battle. No victory or defeat is certain without a battle. So you have to fight it out, you have to go through that grind. Only then you become the chief of the army, or you become the leading chain of hotels or restaurants or whatever.
Correct.
So you cannot take a couple of steps. Okay, you may take a couple of steps initially, just because you are better equipped, you have more finances, maybe your startup is at different levels. But to emerge as a winner, it takes a lot of guts.
I'll just give answer to this. To complete the first part about that educational thing, I'm sure we have must have all seen the movie Guru.
Yeah.
Guru which one?
The Love Guru.
The Love Guru or the
Love Guru? No.
There is Guru by J.K. Pistari.
No.
Abhishek Bachchan.
I know. You're talking about which one? That Yoga Guru. No. I've seen that as well. No, but I'm talking about the Guru, the Mani Ratna.
Okay.
I would say it's a Mani Ratna movie more than Abhishek, because that's the finest acting he's ever done, and the credit has to go to Mani Ratna. Excellent. Now in that, the end of the movie where he's fighting for his own battle in the court, where he says no lawyer, but I will say, but they say, have you completed? He said, Guru Bhai bolenge, but judgment wale day bolenge. Bolenge us din hum log na faisla nahi karenge, something like that they say.
He said, so be it, but I'll speak on the last day because I don't have energy. Last day, he comes all prepared and says couple of important things. You know, if you play that tape, it is, any, you Google it, you'll find it. He says something very important. He said, जब मैंने business शुरू किया, मुझे ये excise duty, ये वो कुछ नहीं आता. No, the parallel which I want to drive here is, when I'm over educated, I'm scared.
Fear.
Like I give an example. I started my thing. I done my MBA and I worked about 3 years in the hotel industry and 3 years into the financial services industry. TDS देना होता है जी. आपको CA के पास जाके कितनी sitting लगानी. No, when you start. You say, मैं सीए का 25,000 का खर्चा दूंगा कि मैं 25,000 में, you know, these things don't strike you.
That's right.
Because in India, we are also not educated and India is a complex country for sure.
Yeah.
And it will continue to be complex because Indians are very sharp. No matter what, Indians are the finest in the world. You know, we had in our hotel a Gora boss, a French boss, it's a French company. And he had just come from an assignment in Thailand. Thailand is considered to be the finest in the world for hospitality. It's got the Oriental is considered the best hotel in the world.
And the king of Thailand is the richest in the world.
Yeah?
Richest.
Okay. So he said that in Thailand, like if you got a, if he's in a restaurant and the table's laid, like salt and pepper set is called a throw-it set in our industry. So he said if the theme of the restaurant is that, you know, on the left hand side corner we create the throw-it set. So whatever the design aesthetic or whatever be the case, that all Thai people will place. He says, if in India we've got about 120 is a huge restaurant by any imagination, a fine dining restaurant. He said, one guy will keep in the middle, one side will keep. That's the problem with you guys. He said, is it a problem? Is the problem you are too intelligent.
So, over
the mind, you will put your mind on that it's okay, it's okay. And we are as such, born and brought up as an argument.
Yeah, room like that, where we are like overeducated that. And, you know, I think I agree with this point. What do you guys think? What do you have to say, Athar? Do you have to comment on it?
Sure. Example, like we are studying at in our school.
What school are you saying?
St. John's. We go there in St. John's. So, whatever we are going to study ahead in our class 1, plus 2, whatever stream we choose, and after we go in our college or anything we do it, it hardly matters with what we are studying right now. Because as you know, there's a sudden bulk of work coming afterwards. And what we study right now, like if I want to go into computer field, it will hardly matter how upward I am. It won't affect me here. So it doesn't mean that education has any disadvantage while going ahead, but it depends which education you're taking. Like if you want to go in computer, I start studying history.
I would differ on that. Working in the education sector, NCERT has set out guidelines. In our country, we have the best education system in the world, but the problem is it is not implemented. NCERT has set the guidelines that if you're studying geography to a level, it is required in your life to probably know the roadmap. To probably, if I'm studying a map, I do marketing and I have a map of Punjab with me. I need to know how to study a map as well. So these level,
but we don't practice what we
exactly. Learn. That is an implementation. The problem.
What I feel is the problem is population.
Yes.
Rather than teaching 10.
I see there is another problem. In my opinion, my thing is that just to take a clue, you know, from what you said, I think the reason why probably we are taught history, geography, algebra is okay. One standard answer is ki hamare dimag ki skills sharp hote hain. But I feel it also gives you better respect for other things in life and a better understanding, like you have to read map. But where I am disconnected with the education system is, ab 9th, 10th mein, those people have to take arts, wo bichare mar ke maths padh rahe hote hain. They are actually going to the mandir every day more time than studying for their maths. So many girls.
I have one of, like I used to get 80 marks out of 100, but I never got interested ki ye hai kya maths. Aaj tak मुझे कभी इंटरेस्ट ही नहीं आया.
So the thing is that I feel if from 8th standard, instead of what we have in 11th, 12th, कि आप sciences लें या arts लें, if it can probably stand at somewhere like the 8th standard, that you know I am 8th is what, when somebody is what 13, 14. So I think if you meet a, like he's about 16, almost the same age. I mean, you look at these 15, 16 years and you feel that you're living in out. I mean, you're living 18th century. The lingo they talk, and I think there is this professor, very famous professor of UGC. I'm unable to recollect his name. So I'm long here. Just to come on TV. Correct?
Yeah,
Yashpal, I think. Yashpal.
he said that every 7 years the technology doubles.
True.
And he said if you add compounding to it, you don't know which world you're talking after 20 years. So I see this is.
We'll give opportunity to the short term. Okay.
I'm not saying that it's bad to study others. Until you, it helps us till a particular stage to be focused and to choose what stream you want. Maybe randomly won't throw an arrow and say that, go ahead. So it should be like that after a particular stage, like you said 8th, I totally agree that after 8th it should be asked from the kid, what do you want to do? The situations are not like this in our country. I tell you, they are not only people of my age. There are people of 24, 25, you ask them kya karna hai. Call centers are like this. I tell you, maximum people of my age are presently thinking that they'll do this, but I tell you, if they find something better, and I think that the path here is easier, they will touch it. And I know quite many people who are in my batch of computer programming. So I tell you, out of them, 80% of them are in call centers. And I hardly understand what we learned in CS.
What do you mean, like they're studying and they're working?
No,
their mindset is going to work.
They've completed their C, Java and all that stuff.
Okay.
And I don't understand how they landed up in a call center. They said, yeah, wahan pe paise mil rahe hain, wahan pe kaam karna hai, but they wahan se baith ke baat karte. They don't understand what is the path you have to take.
Probably they've opted up for the course without a proper vision
guidance
in that
now.
Course.
Yes.
They've just entered a course just for the sake of doing it. That is why they've landed up in a course.
We will have your
listening to your Shitish ne bola ki we have not probably we have one of the best education system. Now we have 2 students here and they are one of, I would say ki they are different from the students outside.
Sure, sure, sure.
That's the reason they are there.
True, absolutely.
Yeah. One thing.
Exactly.
Now, how many of them are here right now? Just 2 of them. The thing is ki ek education system hai, one of the best. बट वो ऐसी एज में उसको इम्प्लीमेंट किया जाता है जहाँ पर स्टूडेंट्स आर नॉट फोकस किया. सेकेंड थिंग इज व्हाट आई फाइंड द रीज़न, जो सबसे बड़ा रीज़न है मेरे को लगता है कि आज सोसाइटी दो आर्गुमेंटेटिव, द रीज़न फॉर बीइंग आर्गुमेंटेटिव इज दैट वी आर वेरी रिलीजियस. एजुकेशन डजंट प्ले दैट मच, वी ऑल नो दैट, बट नॉलेज प्लेज बिगर रोल इन आवर लाइफ. एंड सो टू से स्पिरिचुअल नॉलेज इसको आती है, थोड़ी आती है, वो इस नर्स को और आती है वो थोड़ा ज़्यादा. एंड बींग ऑल कम्स डाउन टू ह्यूमन साइकी अगेन, इतना है लिटिल नॉलेज टू दिस थिंग यू विल बिकम इंग्लिश. सो इसी लॉट को, ये जो हमारा अभी का जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं इनको पढ़ाने वाले जो टीचर्स हैं, दे आर मोर ऑफ प्रीचर्स दैन टीचर्स, दे वॉन्ट बी प्रीचर्स ज़्यादा होते हैं दैन टीचर्स. तो टीचर का काम है कि अभी जो बाहर उन्हें निकलना है उसके लिए फाइट की जरूरत तैयार की जाए, ना कि आफ्टर लाइफ के लिए. बट मोस्टली फोकस ऑन द एरिया की बात करिए एंड कर्मा जो इवेंट बींग मल्टी रिलीजियस सोसाइटी, वन ऑफ द इशूज जो कि मैं हमेशा इसको लेकर समझता हूँ कि ज़्यादा बेसिक में जाएंगे तो ज़्यादातर रूट्स हमें वहाँ तक नहीं मिल सकती हैं. एंड वॉनबी टीचर्स अगेन एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन जो है इट शुड बी अकॉर्डिंग टू, अगेन जियोग्राफी का है. आई एम वेरी मच श्योर लेस देन 50% ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स वो जियोग्राफी पढ़ते हैं. इफ़ यू आर ग्रेजुएट और फिर आप जियोग्राफी उठाएंगे, यू अंडरस्टैंड इट, लाइक यू विल लव टू रीड, बट बिफोर दैट इट विल बी लाइक वो टीचर्स जो होते हैं जो आपके पीछे पड़े हुए ना कि इसको पढ़ो और पास हो जाओ भविष्य.
Probably they are not passionate.
Religious की बात की ना, I had this fortune of being 8 years outside. I stayed in Bombay. For 8 years and then I worked in Bombay and I worked in Bangalore, which was my job. Of course, my father was from an army background, but then of course I was in their protective custody. That's a different thing. But 8 years of hostel life taught me, very personal opinion, no offense here, no nothing against religion. It's all crap. The same boy. I'll give you an example. In hotel management, when we went, there is a card which you make an ID card. Every college has it. But there was a strange thing in Bombay we had. A green card means aap pure vegetarian ho. Grey, I mean it is a card and there is a strip. In that strip it is written Institute of Hotel Management. So it's pretty prominent. You know, it's something like if it is written on the top. Grey means you're a non-veg, non-beef eater. And red means, because in Bombay most of the Hindus eat beef. Please, I'm not trying to get into some controversy, but this is a fact.
Yes, this is a fact.
There is a Vajram Dal guy. I'm just kidding.
Okay. He is. But in the real sense. Not in that sense, in politics sense. Okay.
No, I didn't get him.
So forget it.
We're just joking.
So what happened? We had a Misra. Misra, you know, whatever how you call it. Misra is supposedly the right pronunciation.
It's the same.
Okay, it's the same. But they're supposedly high class pundits. You know. He had a green card for obvious reason first year. Continental food banaya, Indian food banaya. Second year grey because then we went for our hotel training. Third year we had to make the pork, shatru, you know, beef, red. Because when we saw food in the 5-star hotels, which you will say one of the finest in the world, what happens inside? Sir, ice cream has beef in it. We all have it. That's the reason government has said put that green symbol on it. Because gelatin comes from beef bones. Yeah. Now there is something called as a synthetic gelatin. It is very expensive, so people don't use it. So the thing is, and now I'll talk about a religious belief. Hum sare ghar se nikalte hain, especially koi bada kaam ho, parents, kuch exam ho, dahi kha ke jana. Theek hai ji, piche se awaaz maati, oho, ab ruk jao. Achha, paani pe rahe ho, to chini kha lo, paani pe ke nahi jana. The problem is, I do it because my parents like it. But what I feel, by the time I am of their age, वो इतना inculcate होगा कि मैं अपने बच्चों को करूँगा तुम भी जा रहे हो psychological.
अब what so it is the grooming.
I don't. It's
not giving a chance to self reason.
No. It's not the grooming. Why do on Saturday we put that money in that bowl?